Father, you were born into this world, living in our limitations and our hurt. The promise of a healing Savior, fully God and fully man, the sacrifice for all, the spotless Lamb. The great I Am redeemed us with His outstretched hands. Jesus Messiah, firstborn of heaven, perfect salvation to redeem all men. Jesus Messiah, love's definition, willingly broken for all our sin. Jesus Messiah. Never sinned and had no failure. Only through your blood can we be whole again. The great I Am redeemed us with His outstretched hands. Jesus Messiah.
Mary and Joseph lived in the town of Nazareth. During the time Mary was pregnant, the Roman Emperor Caesar Augustus announced that everyone needed to be registered for a census. Since Joseph was a descendant of King David, he and Mary traveled to Bethlehem, the city of David. While they were there, the time came for Mary to have her baby. Mary and Joseph looked for a safe place to stay, but every place was full. So Mary and Joseph found a place where animals were kept, and that is where Mary had her baby. Joseph named him Jesus. Mary wrapped the baby tightly in cloth and laid him in a feeding trough. That night, some shepherds were watching over their sheep in the fields near Bethlehem. Suddenly, an angel stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were terrified. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. I have very good news for you and for all the people. Today, a Savior, who is the Messiah and the Lord, was born for you in the city of David." Then the angel said, "You will find a baby wrapped tightly in cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a whole army of angels appeared, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth to people He favors." When the angels left and returned to heaven,
ooh,
the shepherds decided to go see if the angels' words were true. They hurried to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the feeding trough. Then the shepherds went and told others about the baby Jesus. Everyone who heard about Jesus was surprised and amazed. Mary thought about everything that was happening and tried to understand it. The shepherds returned to their fields, praising God because everything had happened just as the angel said. The birth of Jesus was good news. Jesus was not an ordinary baby. He is God's Son, sent to earth from heaven. Jesus, the promised Savior, came into the world to deliver us from sin and death.
All right, so it kind of makes sense now while I'm standing in a nursery, right? We just learned about the fact that Jesus was born. And I know that right now it is April 5th. It's not Christmas. It's not the celebration of Jesus's birth or anything like that. But right now we can still celebrate the birth of Jesus because, as the song said before the lesson, Jesus is our Messiah. He's the one that came down to earth to die for our sins. And so we celebrate his birth not just on Christmas, but also every day of the week. And you may ask, why would we do that? It's actually kind of difficult sometimes, right, to celebrate Jesus's birth on his birthday. You know, want to know why? Because when we come down the stairs and our big eyes open and there's the tree, and underneath the tree there are all these things that remind us about Jesus. No, wait. There are all these presents that generally take our mind off of Jesus. So maybe today it's best we focus on Jesus's birth, because sometimes we can get caught up in all the other things and forget about what Jesus truly did for us. So today we're focusing on Jesus's birth. And in just a minute, Pastor Brian is going to come and answer a question that I think is very, very important for us to answer, or for us to ask and answer. So he's going to answer that for you. And then I'm going to come back with a couple of questions for us to answer as families.
Hey there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kidz. Victoria from San Antonio, Texas asks,
my friend said Jesus was just a good teacher, but not God. How do we know Jesus was really the Messiah?
That's a really important question, Victoria. Thank you for asking. And you know, your friend is close. We know that Jesus was a good teacher, but he was not only a good teacher. He is the Messiah. He's the Son of God. You know, as we look at the Bible, we see a lot of things called messianic prophecies. If you look in the Old Testament portion, you'll see where God made promises about who the Messiah would be, where he'd be born, his family line, all these different things. And when we look at the life of Jesus, he fulfills those prophecies. I would think that's the greatest way that we can have confidence. We can know for certain that Jesus is the Messiah because he fulfilled those prophecies, many of which you could not manufacture. You can't choose where you're born. You can't choose who your parents are. And so the prophecies alone are great evidence, but there's so much more than that too. We see that Jesus taught with authority. So not only was he a good teacher, he taught differently. As you read the Gospels, you'll see people recognize this. They'll say, he teaches differently. He teaches with authority that nobody else has. But also another great way that we can know for sure that Jesus is the Messiah, he's the Son of God, are his miracles. Jesus performed miracles because he cared about people, but also because he wanted to reveal, without a doubt, that he was special. He could do what we cannot do. And that miracles that he performed affirms that. So we can know that Jesus is the Messiah without a shadow of a doubt. So here's a question back for you. Who can you tell about Jesus?
All right, I've got three questions for you to answer as families. Number one, when you think about the night that Jesus was born, what was the setting like? Now, I know some of your answers may be generic. That's okay, especially if you've got younger ones, talking about what the Bible talks about, where they were and where he was laid and the animals that were around and things like that. But what I want some of you older ones to think about, and parents, so you can kind of guide this discussion with your kids, is what was the feeling like? What was Mary feeling besides pain? What was she feeling? What was Joseph feeling? What was the innkeeper who had to say no feeling? What were the shepherds, the wise men that would start their journey? What were they feeling? What was the setting like? Number two, what should the setting have been like? We're talking about the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, Jesus, Messiah. And yet the setting was as we just described. So what should the setting have been like for Jesus? Now, I know that the Bible tells us that's how he was going to be born, and that was a fulfillment of some messianic prophecies, as Pastor Brian just talked about in the questions for kids. So that was a fulfillment of some of those things, but knowing who Jesus is, what should the setting have been like? And number three, and this one's the most important, who is Jesus to you? Go around the room, ask your kids, ask yourself, everybody give an answer, who is Jesus to you? Because sometimes that setting of our question of who is Jesus to us, we end up giving him this type of setting in our lives, the one that may be a little bit run down, and maybe there's no room for him, and maybe he's not as important as the other guests in the inn, when really the setting should be like that of the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, and the Messiah, and that he has full reign over our hearts and our lives. So answer that question, take some time to dialogue about that. Why is Jesus that way to you? And then how can we do a better job as a family, piggybacking off that question, to make Jesus more prominent in our family's life? You guys ask those questions, and then afterwards there's a couple of videos, some fun songs, and then finally one just to kind of get the wiggles out again. All of them have dance moves, just because who doesn't like to dance, right? But then after those ones, we want to encourage you guys to have a great week. Be on the lookout. Mr. Dwight has another video that's dropping this week. I've got one that'll be coming later on in the week. And so keep an eye out on Facebook and YouTube and all those things for those videos. We love you guys. We can't wait to gather back. Obviously, most of you not here in the nursery, but in your other colored rooms. And be on the lookout for that, because I will be recording in different rooms. So when it's your room, I want you to cheer and, yeah, green room and all that stuff, right? We love you guys. Can't wait to see you again soon.